Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is March 13th, 2023. This is my 22nd episode for C++ Electricity, Magnetism, and Vector Calculus, Classical Physics. This is my third episode for CUDA. Why CUDA over SQL, CUDA Lambda, and Disable Warning? I would highly recommend you these links, for example, Extended Lambda. Double click it. In this page, 14.7 Extended Lambda, you can read more about CUDA Lambda. Also, NVIDIA CUDA Compiler Driver. This documentation gives many useful information about how to use NVCC compiler. Also, using separate compilation in CUDA. This is CUDA Toolkit Documentation Home. This documentation is very useful. I assume you have watched my previous videos listed here, especially episode 20, Hello CUDA, Reinterpret Cast Typecast Pointer to Array. From this video, we will download the source code, download current video source code, show in folder, extract, rename 22, CUDA Lambda. Copy this, paste it in your working directory. Now open up Visual Studio Code, Electricity Magnetism. From folder, we will rename Lambda. Double click it. Ctrl V. I will fold it up. In our previous episode, we created this simple function. Don't miss my previous episode. In episode 19, we installed CUDA Toolkit. In episode 20, we learned how to typecast pointer to array. This method is very powerful. For example, here, constexpr int r n over 2 using array 2 t l T R R. This is R by R array, two-dimensional array. Then, using this technique, G array 2, array 2. Then here, G 2, array 2. We can access our array as two-dimensional array. I will make it smaller. For example, 4. Sorry, it should be 2R. 2 by R array. With this, open up your command prompt. cd 022 CUDA Lambda. NVCC SCD C++ 20 O N.exe Lambda.cu hit enter CLS N X Y added together negative 4 negative 2 gives negative 6 negative 8 negative 1 gives negative 9. C as a single dimensional array. C as two dimensional array. Row 0, row 1. G2 is 2 by 2 matrix. This reinterpret cast is very powerful. You can prevent unwanted bug. Now scroll up. Our element type is a float. Now this is double. Then LT is double. XYZ are now double. As of today, Intel Arc A series graphics devices do not yet support double precision operations. So using SQL, we cannot use type double, but in CUDA, double precision operation is very fast. Now, when we generate random numbers, we will use double. It means we are going to generate double precision. Also, we can access like this, auto E Z2 STD C out E CPG and there. It should be G array 2. We are accessing two-dimensional array. This is a single dimension. We have to use ampersand because array cannot be copied. Now we rebuild CLS N. So all our computation is now double. G as a single dimensional array, G2 as two-dimensional array. Row 0, row 1. This row 0 is here. Row 1 is here. Completely understand how to use reinterpret cast. Now scroll up. We created this simple CUDA kernel in our previous episode. We perform addition against two arrays. Now here type name func type copy paste. It can be L value reference or I value reference. It doesn't matter. But I will prefer L value reference in this case. Then func. Copy this func. Instead of doing this, we say A I B I. The result will be assigned to CI. I will make block. Instead of add, we can say array operation because we are passing arrays as an argument. Now this kernel we call array operation. I will give line break here. Auto addition. We are calling this lambda from device. Auto A, auto B. Semicolon. Return A plus B. Now we pass our lambda addition as parameter. With this, we build again. I have this warning. Lambda requires extended lambda. Now, here, extended lambda. Hit enter. It built successfully. CLS N. This is addition. If you are doubt, we can make it simple by generating integral data type. We rebuild CLS N. 1 plus 8 is 9. 9. Negative 9, negative 9, negative 18. This is addition. Now, scroll down. We can create another lambda. Now, multiplication. We created multiplication lambda. Now, we can pass multiplication. We rebuild. Don't concern about this warning. Declared, but never referenced. CLS N. Now, negative 3, negative 3. Multiplication gives 9. Negative 9 times positive 4 gives negative 36. Now, it is multiplication. Now, we build again. Warning. Variable addition was declared, but never referenced. Copy, paste it here. In C++, class template, function template, lambda template, or is called generic lambda, that are not referenced, are not generated in the executable. So we can ignore unreferenced lambda. However, this warning is very bothersome. So we can disable this warning. If defined NVCC and if here we can use pragma NV dike suppress, then the warning number 177 copy paste. With this, if we build again, we don't have a warning. Before we wrap up this session, we will learn one thing more. Now I will copy disable, paste it here. Here we put lambda directly. Don't miss device. We take auto A, auto B, then return mean value like this. Now we build again. It should not work. No, it doesn't. No instance of function template array operation matches the argument list, this lambda. What's the problem? In this case, I will enable it and disable it. It works without error, without warning. But if I disable it, instead enable it, CLS, it doesn't work. No, it doesn't. To make it work, scroll up. It now should be forwarding reference. We will rebuild. It now should work. Why it does not work? Let's double check. Our lambda, it should return. It returns. But this does not work. Global function cannot have a parameter with R value reference type. This is limitation. I will copy, paste it here. So this is CUDA limitation. Now let's try it. We rebuild. Now it works. And please pay attention to error. Global function cannot have parameter with R value reference type. This is actually forwarding reference, but one limitation in the CUDA global kernel, we cannot take forwarding reference or R value reference. So instead of I value reference, use non-reference type like this. Then you can use this syntax as well as this syntax. Now both works. It works perfectly.